And now I present to you James P. Madonna and the Reverend Dr. William J. Eisenman.
Okay. All right. We're here. Welcome to Progressive Discussions. That's all I'm going to say. Because all the...
All right, end of show.
All, that's it. Ah, we're done. We're done for the week.
Wrap.
It's a wrap. Because everything about us is in the intro to the show. So, you know how much I hate redundance. So why be redundant? Seven bells for not being redundant. Where's my Blackthorn Shillelagh? Well, I guess you would say that this is the post-rigged, corrupt DNC contvention show. Is that an accurate assumption?
End of the week, yeah. End of the month and end of the week.
It is a post-contvention Democratic National Convention. Now, there's still question marks.
Oh.
Now, there's a lot of crapola on the internet about why Bernie Sanders endorsed Hillary Clinton. Some say he was threatened to be removed from his Senate position. He had some kind of a special senatorial position. There's all kinds of...
I think he's on the Armed Services Commission.
If he's been there for about 30 years, I'm sure he's on a lot of commissions, a lot of little things, you know. But the point is this, his wife had said, and look, I don't care if he just received the brand new $175,000 car. I just hope his fat wife can fit in it. That's his business. I'm not asking where the car came from, but he supposedly got one recently. But he got a pretty expensive.
Didn't hear about it.
Yeah, it had a picture of him and driving it. Yeah. Anyway, it's red and black. His wife says, "I'm sorry. You know, we did the best we could. We lost. I'm sorry." She makes it sound like Bernie Sanders had no options. I mean, for God's sakes, he had a formal invitation for months from the Green Party. Never mentioned the Green Party or Jill Stein. No one that I know of from the Sanders campaign team ever mentioned the word Green Party and Jill Stein. But the invitation was formally sent, which was very kind and generous of them. So it's not like the grassroots revolution doesn't have any options. Now, if the grassroots revolution gradually or in large numbers starts flocking to Jill Stein, hey, that's great. But the only
great
good...
because then she'll get on the debates. You have to be like right. 15% in the polls, I believe, before you can get on the debate.
That is correct. Now, the only positive, the only good news I've heard in months is that Bernie Sanders officially quit the Democratic Party.
Yeah, he's back to being independent.
Yeah. You know, some say if he didn't run in the primaries as a Democrat, Bernie Sanders would not have been technically on the map with his grassroots revolution, the America, in other words, he wouldn't have been the household name he is today. He made a bigger name for himself than in the history of his political career by running against Hillary in the primaries,
however, even though
he got creamed.
He would have got more votes if he would have ran as an independent, because he wouldn't have got that Democratic shit that happened.
The rigging? You mean the rigging?
And he would have gotten all the independents.
Yeah, but would he still, would they have still had the debates?
If he
if he ran as an independent.
Yeah, if he got the 15%.
Or I'm sure Hillary,
whatever the rule is, I'm not too sure on it.
Or it might have been Martin O'Malley and Hillary Clinton without Bernie Sanders. Or it might have been all three of them anyway. I don't know.
Could have been.
I don't know, but...
But he would have had more votes, definitely. Because, several of the states would not allow independents to vote in the Democratic primary.
Oh, man, I've been reading so many articles on the different ways of voters were obstructed.
Well, you see what happened in North Carolina?
Oh, my God, it's horrible. It's not just a few ways. It's almost like they sit in a private room behind a big, huge oak table thinking of all these ways to obstruct the American voter.
The Republicans do that.
No, the Democrats.
Oh, well, I'm talking to the Republicans because they just got creamed in North Carolina.
The
court just called them out for being racist.
I'm talking about Hillary's campaign to
Deborah
Wasserman Schultz,
the
DNC's plan to screw Sanders.
Yes.
You know how many ballots were just tossed?
Mm-hmm.
Or hidden, just like dumped somewheres,
mm-hmm.
weren't even counted. He would have, the experts are saying that if it was an honest Democratic primary, Bernie Sanders would have won by a landslide.
That's a possibility.
Because you look at the people who showed up at all the Bernie Sanders rallies versus the people who showed up at the Hillary Clinton rallies. And there's a huge difference. There's no standing room only. There's no lines, long lines of people waiting to get in, and you got to turn them away because there's so many people in the venue. Not with Hillary, but with Bernie. And the fact that so many people walked out there in Hillary Clinton's speech, that sends a message. Of course, after you heard Michelle Obama, who sounded like she just cared about having the first woman in the White House. I mean, it's like, you want to make history? Sure, they made history in 2008 with her husband, Barack Obama, and Ralph Nader warned everybody about him, that he's not going to be working for you. And they didn't listen. They played the race card and called Ralph Nader names. Just like Israel plays the anti-Semitic card, there's the racial card, there's the gender card. All the feminists say, if you don't support Hillary, you're a misogynist. Yeah, you're this, you're that. So what that is, when they play the card, when a lobbying group plays the card, their card, it's a big guilt trip. Like the kind of guilt trip that your mother used, your girlfriend, your wife, they lay the guilt trip, or maybe a daughter with a father. They lay that guilt trip on you, and then you feel guilty, and then they get their way. Except that this is political instead of being on a small scale, in a family environment. This would be political. So, that's it. He's still dry sack sellout Sanders. Deborah Wasserman Schultz, who got a new job as soon as she was disgraced, she got a new job in Hillary's anything Hillary wants to hire her for. Well, if you're infamous in America,
Well, thanks for helping me. That's all about.
You're usually more successful.
Ah!
Infamy increases. your success.
Oliver North, Poindexter, on and on and on and on.
Poindexter, Felix the Cat, I don't care who you're talking about. I know. Oh, where's the levity belt?
I don't know.
There's Poindexter, it's an old cartoon. You millennials wouldn't know. The levity bells. All right, let me expose the Leconcha. Everything we talk about politically is part of our series, Crapitalism in a Conch Shell.
Yeah, capitalism.
Crapitalism truly, really does suck.
Ugh.
Corporate American CEOs should rot in hell, and they also suck. Crapitalism was always rigged, always, since day one. Rigged for the rich. And let me see if King Neptune has anything to say to me. Oh, yeah, I definitely enjoyed that documentary that I watched on the History Channel. I just saw something move. Oh, the spirits are here, man. Oh, yeah. Oh, they're definitely here. I may have to bring my special incense sticks to exorcise them from the studio. Anyway, yeah, I enjoyed it. Nikola Tesla, brand new documentary. Uh-huh. It was awesome. It was awesome how the tower, the great tower that would provide free electricity for the world, in order for Nikola Tesla to get the $150,000 from J.P. Morgan, he had to tell J.P. Morgan that it was for a new radio station.
Yeah.
And then when J.P. Morgan found out what he was trying to do...
Yeah, free energy, what the hell?
Free electricity, free energy, he cut the funding and then and demolished the, I think it was called the Briarcliff Tower or the something...
So
that's what happened, and he was... It started off with Nikola Tesla working for Thomas Edison, and Thomas Edison was in bed with the fat cats, of course.
Well, kidding.
And but you know what's funny? The guy that was telling the story in the documentary says, you know, a company is not going to want to give away their technology for free. It's almost like he was kissing up to them, you know?
Well, everybody is.
Why not? If it's available, if the earth is loaded, if there's electrical current just around in the earth.
Let me expose an analogy.
Alternate current, Nikola Tesla.
We used to have something called free television.
I remember
over
that.
The air. Until Mr. Clinton, El Presidente, giving these rights to cable. And now we don't have free television.
That's when my grandfather would be screaming. I gotta pay for TV to watch TV? I gotta pay? What are you, out of your mind? Oh, spring water in a gallon. You're telling me I gotta pay for water?
Speaking of water, New York's water just got a clean bill of health, baby.
By who?
I don't know. Whoever the hell
tests the
water.
I don't trust them. I'm sure Gary No would not agree.
I know Gary No would not agree.
I don't agree either. Yeah, by who? What are you going to believe? Hey, if I don't believe...
Hey, what are you going to do? Believe him or your lying eyes?
Listen. If I don't believe and trust the USDA and the FDA, how the hell am I going to believe some local political organization that tests tap water quality in Manhattan?
Yeah, local.
For de Blasio, who's got some skeletons in his closet.
Ooh.
Of course he does. He endorsed Hillary Clinton. Him and his wife.
I did not see his speech. And they did not even show Chucky Schumer's speech.
Chuck Schumer, who likes Timothy Kaine. Now, hey, Hillary could sound as progressive can be, all she wants.
And she is.
She is. If she's elected, She might become a centrist, or she might go all the way to the right.
Well, she's going to break up the Wall Street banks now.
Oh, cut it out, guys. That's naughty. What is that? She said, "Yeah, come on, guys,
no,
cut
no,
it out."
Now they work together to put all these Bernie things into the plank, into the platform. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, Bernie was had an obsession with saving the Democratic Party, and for some reason he just wanted to save it. It's kind of like bailing out a corporation. Yeah. Hey, you know, man, there's a lot of great smaller growing companies that could easily take the place of any corporation or any bank, any big bank. There's somebody waiting in the wings that can do the job better and do it honestly than you can. So if somebody big screws themselves and they go belly up,
bye bye.
You know what? Green, like the banner says, green is the new blue. Because blue with the donkey used to be like green is, like the Green Party is now. They used to be truly progressive liberals. Okay? And now that's not the case. So that's why the banner says the new blue is green. I can only speak for myself. Right now, I'm endorsing Jill Stein. If Bernie comes to his senses, Bernie Bird, and he wants to take up the Green Party on their offer, hey man, more the merrier. That'll just bring more massive legions of grassroots We the People over to the Green Party. If he doesn't, he doesn't. But I'm not gonna lose sleep over it. Oh, by the way, was that a good choice of me ordering the B-Complex 100 capsules from Swanson Vitamins to give myself a better feeling?
What if you
energy?
Yeah, but what if you become more hyper?
I'm only hyper because I had Latin espresso coffee.
Well, don't have it.
I had a Cafe Bustelo. I have to have. Vim and vigor and vitality and enthusiasm. It's a show. It's being recorded. I could take a nap all I want later on when the show's over. I could lay around and lollygag around, you know, but you know. First of all,
if I'm taking 100 milligrams of B complex.
Yes.
I would take it for until the bottle runs out, and then I would change to B50. And make sure I take it at every meal,
bees are important.
They convert energy, energy.
That's why I picked the 100 milligrams.
But if you take B vitamins before you want to retire and go to sleep, it will keep you up.
No, I'm not taking it at night. I will be a fool.
I'm not talking about you. I'm talking in general.
Well, it's also not a good idea to take anything that is known as a stimulant.
Right, before bedtime.
It could be ginseng, it could be, I don't know, whatever. You know. But anyway, you gotta have a meal in your stomach before
yes,
you take supplements.
Vitamins are to be taken with meals.
Yeah.
They work with food, they are synergistic
except,
with food.
Except for things like bovine colostrum, which is recommended.
Or branched-chain aminos, which are taken between meals.
Yeah, so what you would do in the case of colostrum, which is immunostimulating, you would take it like as soon as you get up and wait a half hour or so, then have your breakfast. The only thing I can think of, because how many people truly have an empty stomach when they go to bed?
Yeah, well,
you know what I mean, with all the snacking that Americans do, and I know I snack. Anyway,
I know snack.
No, you don't. Now, let's do a little Chiseler's Hall of Shame.
We have a Chiseler.
I only have one. My mother's new caregiver. She had, I don't know if she still has it, but she had bought the famous New Wave oven. You know the infomercial where it's convection and infrared and this and that and blah, blah, blah. It's the one where they put the frozen turkey, you know, they put the see-through dome on top of a frozen turkey, and in record time, it cooks it to perfection, browned and everything.
Never saw it.
Anyway, it's one of the big infomercials, like the Ninja and the NutriBullet RX, and, you know, it's one of the big ones.
What's the brand?
Has a good reputation. Well, it's called the New, capital N-U, New Wave Oven. There's another company that tries to make a copycat. But anyway, what happened?
Breville.
Yeah, now, the caregiver said it works fantastically.
Oh.
But one day she was cooking barbecue chickens in there, and the dome lid, the see-through dome lid, burst. It cracked and busted. She contacted the company. The company says, we do not sell a replacement dome lid. You have to buy a whole new wave oven.
Oh yeah, come on.
What a scam that is. What bullshit that is. Deeper. Come on, give me a break. Buy a whole new wave oven. All she needed was the dome lid. I smell a little scam there.
All right, but I'm not placing this here. Is the oven like a rectangular oven, regular oven?
No, it's, well, so what is this it's electronic. It's round.
Uh-oh, here we go.
It comes with a rack for vegetables, and, you know, it's an all-purpose. The dome is exactly like a dome, like
but it's like shutting the door to an oven, right?
No, you.
If you don't have the dome, you don't have an oven, right?
You ain't got shit.
Okay, well,
you know, like the dome that goes on top of. Let me finish.
I know that.
You know, like the dome that goes on top of a wok.
Yes.
Right. Okay. It's a see-through.
I got the picture.
See-through dome, that is supposed to be very heat resistant. Well, it burst. They don't sell the replacement part. They say you gotta buy a whole new one. Hey, fuck you. This, now you see how underhanded the American retail industry truly is? How rotten to the core they are?
Well, this is not something new, my friend.
It's like the diamond industry, and I know we talked about it so many times. Mm-hmm. Speaking of, I want to salute my sixth Facebook group called the St. Valentine's Day Massacre on Our Wallets. It's a male activist group, and I think we discussed the Beers Mining Company, how they purposely control the exportation of the diamonds, because whether they be blood diamonds or not, there are so many diamonds being mined that the diamond is no longer a precious gemstone, and they control the price by holding back. So all those K Jeweler, Jared. What's that other one? There's another company that advertises all the bullshit that make the men feel guilty if they don't spend their life savings on a diamond that's not even worth it. K Jeweler, Jared, and there's a third one. It'll come to me. But anyway, the diamonds are not worth that much. Now, I had a diamond. Unless a diamond, even if a diamond comes with a Gemological Institute of America certificate of authenticity, that it has no inclusions in it, and it's clear. Guess what? It has to be super perfect to even be considered an investment. But it's not an investment anymore, because the diamond is truly not a precious gem. You're better off buying
It's not worth what you pay for it.
Practically, a woman is better off with a good cubic zirconia. It looks better than a real diamond. It costs a tiny fraction of the price. You're not being ripped off by the American retail jewelry industry. You're not being a sucker. You're not being victimized. And it looks fantastic. So that's about it. Anyway.
So they're going into the Chiseler's Hall of Shame.
Chiseler's Hall of Shame. Shame on you, the company that makes the new wave oven. Not that the new wave oven is bad. Not that it doesn't work. But you're pulling a scam. I'm sorry.
It seems to me, if I'm understanding the structure and everything, it seems to me that with that particular oven, you got no under the broiler.
No, it browns. It has the speed of a microwave. It browns like a convection. You know, it's a convection, infrared, halogen. In other words, they take all the modern technologies of heating and they put it all together.
Yeah, but the thing is in one place, whereas in a regular oven or a convection oven, you got the top rack, you got the middle rack, and you got the bottom rack.
All right, so the dome, there's a see-through dome. Make believe my teacup is upside down. There's tea in it, so I'm not going to turn it upside down. And if that cracks or bursts, they should sell the part. Why should people buy a whole new oven?
Well, that's capitalism.
That's underhandedness.
That's American stuff. Americans do not replace their things or fix their things. They buy a new one.
You know what it's like? It's like a living in bizarro world where where being crooked and unethical becomes the norm.
It is the norm.
Becomes the accepted norm.
Have you been living under a rock for the last 50 whatever years? It is the norm. This is America.
And what makes that so damn special? Because it's America?
Because that's the norm. We are cheaters.
Yeah, that's obvious.
We are filthy.
That's obvious.
You know, and the
Scandinavians are the ideal on the planet Earth. The ideal system. What can I say? The most fair system known to man is what Northern Europe has.
Well, we'll see.
And they deserve to get a salute by my lucky black
kudo,
horn.
Kudo, an accolade.
Shillelagh. Accolade?
Yeah, accolade.
Is that like a
kudo, kudo.
A kudo. Okay, all right. You know what? I can't think of anything else to say because I don't know what Bernie Sanders... I don't know if Bernie Sanders has a plan C. We don't know yet. Plan A is when he ran in the primaries against Hillary Clinton. Plan B is when he lowered himself, sucked it up, and endorsed Hillary to get his delegates and his ass in the convention building to be able to speak
and get his platform.
Right. That whole negotiating platform bullshit.
Yeah.
And I could care less about the future of the DNC.
Which Hillary does not have to obey.
She don't have to obey anything.
No.
She don't have to obey anything.
No.
Plan C is what he can do next, now that he's not in the Democratic Party, which is take up the Green Party on their offer. Either that, or go back to Vermont, pour maple syrup on your buckwheat pancakes, play with your grandchildren, and just, you know, enjoy the rest of your retirement.
I think that's where he's going to go.
You think he's not going to go green?
Oh, no. I don't think so at all.
What is wrong with, if you're running a campaign that's supposed to be very progressive, right? And you're giving all those speeches that are extremely progressive and socialist, okay? And you're talking about grassroots revolution. What is so wrong with honoring those speeches by going with Jill Stein?
Because Bernie is 74 years old.
So let
he ran a big fight.
So if he croaks, Jill Stein will take over.
Well, if you look at it that way, that's fine, but he's exhausted.
I can imagine.
You know, it...
Hillary's health is not like...
The whole thing with him...
100% either.
The whole thing with him was, he It is the people who make the revolution. He did what he could.
Wanted to get the chain reaction going, yeah. The domino effect.
Yes.
He wanted the opportunity. He wanted to lay the groundwork where many other
socialists... down a hill.
Right, because he probably knows he's an old geezer. He's probably ready to take a nap like Rip Van Winkle. But he wanted to get that snowball down the mountain.
Yeah.
Rolling. Which is a positive thing, because I'm sure, I know there already are grassroots revolution real progressives popping up all over the country. New Jersey has them. Huh?
Like mushrooms.
Yeah, New Jersey's got them all over the country. There are all the former Bernie-crats that want to get into politics, much younger people, are popping up all over. And I'm sure Jill Stein is going to lay her progressive groundwork.
Yeah.
And she's going to...
She's kind of limited because she ain't getting no exposure. She ain't got no exposure.
The only way she can be on the map is if the former Bernie legions flock to her. And from what I understand... They're angry, as they're pissed off, they're disgruntled, and they are flocking to her. Let's see what happens. I don't know.
Yeah, and then give her the 15% that she needs in the polls to get into the debates.
See, that's the key.
She will get the exposure.
Where's the fucking shillelagh? See, that's the key to be able, not just to be on the ballots. That's a given. That will be, by November, that will be done.
Yeah.
But to get in the debates,
yes,
to make the Emperor Donald Trump and the Empress Hillary Clinton look really bad. And Jill Stein has the capability of doing that.
You think Bernie was a progressive? Wait till you see Jill Stein.
Jill Stein will tear the both of them a new asshole.
Exactly.
And you know, she's a woman, but I know I feel in my core that she will be much tougher than Bernie Sanders was in the debates, without a doubt.
Yeah, because she'll have nobody to alienate.
Whereas
Bernie had to be careful to walk on eggshells in the Democratic Party.
He had to not make big waves in the DNC.
That's
he didn't want to make waves in the DNC. He got screwed anyway.
Exactly.
he was trying to be so nice and diplomatic that he ended up getting totally screwed anyway. So if he came out with both six shooters going
and ran as an independent. Right. Things might have been better.
Hey, look. I'm not a senator. I'm not a college graduate. And both of us here are coming up with all these ideas. Bernie. You should have thought of these things at the beginning. You have personally placed the Bernie bird, who was the word, into a bag of shake and bake. No exaggeration. You fricasseed the bird. Shame on you. Shame on you, Bernie Sanders. But I don't want to go on a tirade tearing apart Bernie yet, because he quit the Democratic Party. He might have a plan C. I don't know what's going through that coconut skull of his. I don't know. Anyway.
Only time will tell.
Only time will tell. And it's not time yet. So I don't want to go off half-cocked. Now, I did go off on the kitchen sink Iker.
Hey, he went after somebody the other day, man.
For supporting and defending Hillary Clinton to Alex Jones and being rude to the great Alex Jones, you no-neck fatso. being rude to the great Alex Jones of InfoWars. Man, Alex Jones. You may be a little too right-wing for me as a libertarian, but you're all right in my book. I do agree with a lot of the things you post and what you say. All right, I like progressiveness, but I like the kick-ass qualities of a I don't know if I should say moderate libertarian. Now, the great Gary Johnson, former governor of New Mexico, he's libertarian, but he's moderate or if he's progressive.
Who knows?
He says
you don't hear much of him.
He says a lot of great things on banners. I was ready. I was trying like hell to post a great Gary Johnson banner on the Progressive Discussions Facebook page, but the Facebook security team kept on blocking me from posting one of Gary Johnson's great banners. Little corporate coke sucking corporatist capitalism there in Facebook.
I wonder if Facebook is responsible for the fact that I cannot see all of the videos that I click on.
You know what? I heard...
All I get is the buffering.
I heard that the certain internet entities have been blocking and censoring the very progressive videos.
Well, Google does it. Google tracks
you. Oh, really?
Google tracks you.
Track you? I'll track you right across the skull with my shillelagh.
There are...
I don't need a shillelagh. See this USDA grade A fist? The five knuckles shuffle?
Knuckle sandwich.
You can track me all you want. We are against censorship, and we always were.
Well, some porn sites...
Porn is great.
And I don't know if this is, a come on to want to try to...
Come on, C-U-M.
Want to try to, Hey, careful.
My shillelagh almost went flying. I said come, C-U-M.
Some porn sites allow you to click on something that says stop Google's tracking. Okay? Mm-hmm. Now, I don't know if that's something to allow them to, get into your computer or something, or if it's actually true.
Yeah.
Hey, Google, but they do have that.
Got an itch in the middle of my forehead.
For people who don't want their history tracked and don't want Google tracking them what they're doing online. Want to visit a porn site, they want to visit a porn site without Google tracking them.
I heard Mark Zuckerberg puts like masking tape over his webcam lens.
Well, that's a smart thing to do because they can do it through your telephone.
Well,
they can hear the conversation in the room through your phone.
I heard they can, the new flat screen TVs?
Same thing.
I hear there's a device in there that they can... Holy crap. Somebody's watching me is a song from the 1980s. I think that somebody's watching me. It was a good song.
The lock her up chants, a fan favorite among Republicans since the GOP convention last week, begun about 45 minutes into Donald Trump's speech here on Friday.
Lock her up. Hillary for prison 2016, Alex Jones t-shirts.
Oh yeah?
Hillary for prison, yeah.
But instead of issuing his stock response to the refrain, he issued during his acceptance speech, tamping it down with a call to defeat Hillary Clinton in November. The GOP presidential candidate told supporters he's starting to agree with calls for his Democratic rival's incarceration.
I heard Donald Trump wants to physically punch out some people from the Democratic convention for mocking him. He does not like to be mocked.
Really?
Yeah, he had his fist up. I was looking for the video, I couldn't find it, but he's going to want to punch him in the face.
I've been nice, Trump said. But after the lies of Clinton's convention speech on Thursday night, I don't have to be so nice anymore. I'm taking the gloves off.
Donald, do it, because you are a...
What do you mean, do it? He's already done it.
No, take Take the other layer of gloves off, you are a prime source of entertainment for me. I thank Donald Trump for providing me with much political entertainment that better than I've ever seen in my life. I thank you for your entertainment.
With his declaration of no more Mr. Nice Guy, Trump seemed to signal a new phase in this already chippy presidential campaign.
You know, somebody posted a message under one of our shows. It said, get out the popcorn, everybody. Get out the popcorn.
Well, that would indicate to me a very studious person that would actually sit down, chew on some popcorn, and watch the damn show.
I think that means we're rather entertaining.
Yeah, whatever.
And educational, you pencil neck geeks. Don't you forget that. All right, go ahead, continue.
In his first public appearance since the close of the Democratic convention, Trump unleashed fresh jabs at Clinton.
Punch him in the face.
He called her a Thursday night speech, in which she became the first woman to accept the major party presidential nomination, so average. He delighted in newly released television ratings that found the viewership for his nomination acceptance speech was higher than that for Clinton.
You know what? She's underestimating Donald Trump. The polls, she better be careful. She's, you know what I mean? I'm telling you. Bernie Sanders might end up being the only chance for the Democratic Party to defeat Donald Trump.
But the real estate mogul also spent a significant portion of his remarks relitigating some of his more controversial moments in the GOP primary. He addressed his nearly year-old remarks about Fox News anchor Megyn Kelly.
Ooh, I think he wants to bang Megyn Kelly. He should come clean and just tell her.
After whose performance as moderator in the first debate in August, he described as having blood coming out of her nose, blood coming out of her whatever. Yeah. Sounds kind of messy to me.
I think he would bang her if she was on the rack.
With blood coming out of everywhere?
You gotta be real horny.
Oh my God,
gotta make sure you lay down a towel. You know, if you're gonna do that. Old enough to bleed. Old enough to butcher.
I was talking about her nose. Maybe her ears, she explained.
And whatever.
Not implicitly referring to menstruation.
Well, whatever doesn't mean... Whatever doesn't mean menstruation. Whatever means whatever.
Could be from her ass.
It could be from the ceiling. She could have like demons in her house, or blood coming out of walls, or I don't know. Whatever does it. It look. In a court of law, whatever is whatever. Whatever doesn't mean anything specifically. That's what I'm trying to say.
He then went on a long riff about his feud with New York Times reporter Sergei Kovalevsky.
Oh, is that
sparked by the reporter disputing Trump's characterization that thousands of Muslims celebrated the terrorist attacks of September 11th.
That wasn't him. That was another guy.
No, that's the one you said you also saw.
On September 11th, what the hell was it, 2001?
Yes.
2001. They had cameras and a reporter on Main Avenue in the Islamic community, Middle Eastern community in Paterson, New Jersey, on Main Avenue, and they were jumping up and down for joy as the buildings came down.
Joy was there?
Joy Behar? Or Joy.
Joy Behar is on The View.
Regis Philbin's wife, Joy.
Oh,
Joy Behar? Oh, no, Joy Behar wasn't there.
In November, Trump mocked Kovaleski, drawing in his arm and using jerky movements.
She's a very smart one.
Oh, yeah, so it is.
She's funny, too.
He is the disabled guy.
Oh, the. Oh, that was it.
I don't remember what I said.
Well, I'm telling you, man, Donald Trump, man, I don't know. He's a showman. I enjoy listening to him. I won't vote for him, but I enjoy listening to him.
The impression...
And watching.
...resembled the reporter's disability. But Trump denied he meant to be deliberately mocking.
Well, he put his hands in the same way. He made the same bodily emotions.
Whatever he does, and he finds out later it's wrong, he always changes it. Okay, he always backtracks.
I put fresh echinacea leaves in my tea, by the way, from the garden. Just want to tell you.
On Thursday, Trump insisted he was simply doing an impersonation of somebody groveling.
Yeah, with your hand like this?
And said, attacking the disabled is not in my vocabulary.
Well, if you keep on replaying the video, his hand and his arm went the same way that the Kondoleski guy does, you know.
Despite being months old, both comments had figured prominently into Clinton's attacks.
Of course she's going to dig up everything.
Particularly as the Democrat seeks to woo independent women in November. Attendees at the afternoon rally, held in an auditorium at the University of Colorado's campus in Colorado Springs, said they want to see Trump continue his brash, unpredictable persona in the general election.
They enjoy it. They enjoy it. He's more brash and unpredictable and obnoxious than, let's say, even Chris Christie.
Oh, God.
Yeah, I mean, he's very entertaining. People, Americans love to be entertained. Oh, he can't ask Megyn Kelly to have sex because he's married. His wife might get very angry.
Let Trump be Trump!
Yes, Trump. Trump will always be Trump, and let him be Trump.
Ernie Albertson, a retired general contractor from Colorado Springs, said he appreciated Trump's realism, particularly when he accepted the GOP nomination in Cleveland last week. The way he comes off is off the cuff, and as a true American, he said.
A true American.
It's great.
See, that's the funny part of anyone that's on a right winger, you know. A real American. A true American. That's like when, when Ken Create would say, oh, he or she is a big time Christian, or a believer, a real believer.
Because.
So what does that mean? They're better than us?
Republicans have a monopoly on patriotism, my friend. Okay.
So if you have perpetual wars for profit, yeah, and you send the children of the poor and middle class to die in those wars, and you don't want them to come back because then you have to take care of them. Ugh. So I guess that you're being patriotic, going for all that war profiteering, war mongering, and not helping the poor, and not helping the veterans when they come back.
And it's good for business.
So that's patriotic.
There you go.
To be a to allow yourself to be a victim is patriotic.
The right wing believes, after Afghanistan and Iraq, and etc., the right wing believes that our military does not want to fight. That's what they believe.
No, they just want to occupy the whole world.
Yeah.
With all their bases.
Yeah.
I heard the Turks are getting pretty tough with the American base.
Erdogan, or however you pronounce his name, has just accused the United States, and of course it's probably true, of being in on the coup. I got news for you. They probably instigated it, as usual.
Well, the Turks tried very hard to make up with Vladimir Putin. I think, you know, they apologized for shooting the
airplane down,
and they're, but there's a lot of shit going down, brother. That's all I know. The media censored what's going on in Turkey with the U.S. base.
Of course. What, are you kidding me?
The media censored. That shows you who controls the media. Yeah. The so-called biased liberal media is a complete lie.
Oh, yeah, to be a liberal media. Yeah. It's been around for decades. Yes, yes.
Bullshit. Anyway, we're going to break for lunch, and you will be joined by our voiceover artist, William Hamilton Morrow III, with promo and the How to Defeat a Conservative Bible Verses. Simply hit pause, read, and learn. You think you can do that, America? Read and learn?
It might be even better if they got the newsletter and read How to Defeat a Conservative.
Brand new issue, hot off the pancake griddle.
Damn.
Get your subscription, but you'll hear more about it from William H. Morrow, the Thoid.
This is William H. Morrow. The best way to join our organization is to get your free annual subscription to Newsletter Censored with your gift to support this work. The newsletter of hard-hitting truth and news fighting censorship and conservative propaganda since 1977. There is nothing out there like the Newsletter Censored in the mainstream media or the press. This newsletter is the very best way to join and be a part of our organization. We're living the end times, so you need Newsletter Censored. Go to www.newslettercensored.com. Hey, listen, for the real hard-hitting truth, you need Newsletter Censored. And now, back to the show. Bye-bye.
Okay, we're back. Thank you very much, William Hamilton Morrow III, for doing promo. Now, for the balance of our show, Progressive Discussions, the Post, Democratic National Cuntvention Show.
Hey. Show.
Don't forget capitalism in a conch shell. Don't forget that conch energy.
I watched the Republican convention.
Yeah.
To see if the party does in fact have any solutions for this nation's problems.
Don't hold your breath.
I didn't see any.
No, the solution is, unless you're rich, die.
But Governor Christie's speech was particularly disturbing. Not because of what he said, but because he seemed to completely ignore the very basis of the American justice system. He prosecuted Hillary Clinton from his bully pulpit.
Yeah, why not?
And asked a jury of her peers to convict her of crimes she has not even been indicted for.
She's guilty as a dickens.
That's hardly innocent until proven guilty.
Oh, this guy's a wuss.
Let's say she should have been indicted for some of the events he mentioned. Doesn't the American justice system say that everyone, no matter how heinous his or her alleged crime, is entitled to a defense?
What if it's a kangaroo court? What if they do what the FBI did?
Well, wait.
Turn a blind eye.
A kangaroo court would not allow a defense. And that's what this gentleman is yapping about.
What he's talking about is an honest court of law.
Yeah, well, Christie wasn't allowing that. That's his point. Christie was acting as Judge Dredd.
Yeah, because Chris Christie, like myself, he despises Hillary Clinton. So he went off on an emotional tangent, tirade. That's what it was.
This is one of the tenets that differentiates our justice system from others. You would think this former U.S. attorney for New Jersey would be aware of that. Yet Christie completely ignored this. He may have made his case, but he did not allow for any defense from the accused before pronouncing her guilty. It sounded more like fascist rabble-rousing than anything else. Clinton bashing was inevitable at this convention, as I'm sure Trump bashing will be at the Philadelphia one. But shame on Christie for perverting the American justice system.
Shame on Christie for
being Christie.
Ignoring the victims of Hurricane Sandy and only helping the business owners.
You know that there are some people still have not recuperated from Sandy?
I heard New York State did a hell of a lot more for its Sandy victims than Chris Christie did.
Donald Trump's acceptance speech at the Republican National Convention did exactly what he wanted to do.
Get nominated.
Trump painted a dark picture of America and positioned himself as the only candidate who can fix it.
Oh, really?
Yes, he did.
He has that much...
I'm the only one who can fix it, he said.
He has that much expertise and knowledge to handle the job, huh?
Yes. He can fix the troubles and dismantle its rigged system. In a speech light on facts and completely devoid of policy details, although he did reiterate his plans to build a wall, Trump promised to be America's voice, to win for us, restore law and order, create jobs, reduce taxes, and fight terrorism. He even looked somewhat presidential while doing it. That is exactly why I am terrified people will watch his speech and buy into the fear-mongering and divisiveness it preached. For someone who has spent his entire life as a builder, Trump should know that you cannot erect a strong building on a flawed foundation.
Yeah, that's true.
Trump's distorted vision of America, what it should be. An America that demonizes immigrants, bans Muslims,
ignores systemic racism, backs out of its NATO commitments, turns its back on Syrian refugees, and is safe with more guns on the street, is the cracked foundation on which he wants to build his administration. His vision is contrary to so much America stands for, and I'm afraid our country will crumble under a Trump presidency.
You see, getting back to Donald Trump's South of the Border wall.
The wall, yeah, baby.
See, Mexican people that illegally cross the border to work in the United States, they have no choice. Many of them have no choice because in Mexico they have terrible poverty. So when they sneak across the border to work in the United States, in which the American companies gladly hire them, because they work cheaper, right?
Yeah.
They do it out of necessity, because the immigration system in the U.S. is so damn strict since 9/11. I mean, you have to have money and a profession and this and that. I mean, the stipulations are so strict with immigration now, that they normally, being that they're so poor, they normally can't come into the United States to work
legally.
But don't come down on the poor Mexicans. Come down on the American companies who gladly hire them.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
A 63-year-old former Swiss Air Force pilot and a hypnotherapist, 5 years his junior, with a penchant for hot air balloon exploration, completed a round-the-world trip in a solar-powered airplane.
That is very true. That it's like the I guess, what would you call it, the Charles Lindbergh of the 21st century? Solar power, the first solar-powered airplane to be able to safely make this long of a journey.
And predicted that within a decade, commercial flights with electric aircraft will become a reality.
Well, I don't think they would have the speed. I know the electric vehicle definitely has the speed and the acceleration. You know, like the Tesla car?
Excuse me.
God bless you. Yeah, like the Tesla car, I saw...
Speaking of Tesla.
I saw the Tesla car in action.
BMW is going to bring out a car to compete with the Tesla.
Which is good because it brings prices down.
BMW would bring down prices?
No, I mean competition is supposed to bring down prices.
Supposed to, yeah, but not with BMW being on the other end. You know? I don't trust that.
Yeah. But I mean, the more companies start coming out with these long-range electric vehicles that can attain high speeds quickly, I mean, it'll get better. We're still waiting for the high-speed rail system in the United States. We don't have that yet.
Bertrand Picard, 58.
Oh, Captain Picard.
Touched down in his solar impulse at 4:05 a.m. in Abu Dhabi.
That's where he touched down?
United Arab Emirates.
Gee, an American?
Completing the final leg of a 16-month multi-stage journey.
Couldn't he touch down in a safer part of the world for an American?
I guess it depends where he started. And I don't know where that was.
I don't know either.
The project team said in a statement on Tuesday, The plane has flown 26,750 miles since starting the trip in March 2015.
Wow.
I am sure that within 10 years, we will see electric airplanes transporting 50 passengers on short to medium haul flights.
And if you see that in 10 years, I'm sure you will see mini versions for perhaps one or two passengers zipping around like George Jetson. Got that, Elroy?
But it's not enough. The same clean technologies used on solar impulse could be implemented on the ground in our daily life.
Yeah, like light rails and high-speed rails.
Picard took turns at the controls with André Borschberg.
Borsch, that is a cold beet soup that is very tasty.
To circumnavigate the globe without using any fuel. Each pilot was allowed 10 to 20 minute naps over the course of 24 hours. And the longest leg of the journey took 5 days. Solar Impulse flew near the Statue of Liberty and Egypt's pyramids for photo opportunities, and was grounded for more than a half a year in Hawaii due to battery overheating along the way.
Well, if they utilize Tesla's free worldwide electricity towers, you would have a backup source instead of depending on the sun. But anyway, the technology has been around for a while. It was just suppressed.
The electric car is over 100 years old.
Oh, absolutely. 1920s, I think. Like in the days of the Ford Model T. Yeah, there was actually the first electric car way back then.
Yep. You know? There is so much potential for the aeronautical world, Borschberg said. While 100% solar-powered airplanes might take longer to materialize, the electric airplanes will develop in the near future.
You know, Nikola Tesla, I don't know if it was the late 1930s or what, but experiment where he took a Pierce Arrow automobile and converted it to 100% electric was a great success, and he was able to travel at high speeds and everything with his Pierce Arrow, and he had witnesses, and you know, he presented it
nice
to a panel of engineers and such, and it was a 100% success. And then it got buried. Kaput.
On my return as a delegate from the Republican National Convention, I heard a lot of commentators say Donald Trump's acceptance speech was too dark.
Everybody in this, all these readings, they seem to be all, everybody focusing on attacking Donald Trump, but nobody seems to be hammering Hillary Clinton, I notice. Probably the source of the readings where, you know.
I did not see that at all. It was a frank and realistic assessment of the state of affairs of the nation, and very powerful. Don't the commentators know that 70% of Americans say the country is headed in the wrong direction? We needed an honest evaluation of the nation so people can know the truth and how to correct the problems.
Honest evaluation. Yeah, Washington basically sold the voter out. to the top 1%. That's it.
Trump knows people are disconnected and hugely dissatisfied with their government. He will speak for them when the doors are closed and the politicians are cutting deals. Trump will be the one to stop the Environmental Protection Agency from regulating coal jobs out of this country.
Let the planet Earth get more polluted. Pollute everything for the sake of profit and so-called jobs. I wonder how well they're going to pay.
To stop the Justice Department from taking our guns. And to stop the IRS from overtaxation.
Who? The middle class? Or is he talking about the rich?
The rich, of course. While hedge funds and Wall Street get a pass, Trump knows the political correctness has beaten the spirit of this country. Notice he clarified his position on Muslims.
Just annoying.
The liberal media say a ban is not possible.
The liberal media.
Yet the American people respond with support for Trump. Americans are smart and know he just wants to stop dangerous Islamic terrorists from coming into this country and killing innocent, freedom-loving Americans. Trump will be a forceful leader on the world stage after President Obama's red lines and Hillary Clinton's white lies.
White lies?
He will not tour the world apologizing for America or coddle enemies of America, including Iran. Remember when President Jimmy Carter coddled the Iranians?
Oh, because the Iranians can't stand Israel. Everybody that hates Israel is an enemy, is a problem. Israel stole the land from the Palestinians.
What about Oliver North and Ronald Reagan selling missiles to Iran?
Yeah, that too. Right.
Average Americans know what has been happening in this country under Obama. Clinton is wrong. Americans feel helpless at the hands of political correctness. Trump will break this cycle of insanity and begin a new era of American greatness.
Greatness for which Americans vote. Top 20% perhaps?
Yeah.
That's the disclaimer at the bottom corner of every Republican speech.
I have not been so beset with anxiety since, as an 8-year-old boy, I witnessed the Nazis marching into Austria in 1938.
Yeah, come
on. The Republican candidate has given every indication of being an autocrat who thinks he knows how to fix everything and intends to do it with a magic wand.
The magic wand of invasion, occupation, and stealing?
Yeah.
Perhaps. Most likely, rather.
Without regard to any legislative branch or the Constitution. His remark that the Constitution is not a suicide pact is a clear indication that he does not intend to abide by it if it runs counter to his agenda. His convention call for putting his opponent in jail is reminiscent of all autocratic regimes that seek to jail those who would dare oppose them. Even more frightening is the fact that the convention took up the chant. His admiration for the autocrat of Russia, Vladimir Putin, is also telling.
Vladimir Putin is a real-life worldwide superhero who's bombing the dickens out of ISIS.
While the followers of Bernie Sanders seek a very different America from the one that Trump seeks, they too refuse to see the tremendous progress this country has made during the 8 years of the Obama administration.
Tremendous progress? He spent the whole 8 years trying to fix what G.W. Bush and Cheney did, the damage they did.
I saw somebody write the other
what
day.
What progress?
That when Obama got into office, the national debt was $9 trillion.
Yeah.
Now it's 19. Where's that person been? $9 trillion 8 years ago.
Well, listen.
What, George Bush didn't add to the debt at all?
When you're dealing with the Democrats that usually get funded by the oligarch, you're still dealing with the establishment. It's just slightly lesser of the two evils. That's all. Slightly lesser. You know, Obama. You know, he did what he did. Obamacare provided many, many poor people with a health insurance they never had before, which is good. He fixed a lot of the debt. He did the best he could. But
two-thirds.
But he's pro TPP.
There's another one now. I think it's TIPP.
TIPP?
Something like that.
And he wrote the Monsanto Protection Act. Protect Monsanto?
Yeah.
Who's going to protect us from Monsanto? You know, so he's a corporatist like Hillary Clinton. It's the same problem continues. Two-party system, capitalism. Everything's rigged for the rich. It just goes on and on and on. And Americans are too stupid to see the real truth.
Obama accomplished so very much despite Republican majorities in the House and Senate for most of his presidency.
Oh, the do-nothing Congress, yeah. That takes vacations all the time.
Despite the constant destruction from the Republican Congress, Obama has revived an economy that has added more than 9 million jobs, and a jobless rate has dropped to 4.9%. As for the stock market, the Dow Jones average rose from 7,600 when Obama took office to about 18,450 today.
You think Obama's waiting until he leaves office before he lowers the boom about all the racist obstructionism he had to endure? I mean, he's been able to keep his composure very well.
Yeah.
For a man.
So I guess that means there will be a book in the works when he leaves office.
Isn't there always a book in the works?
Okay.
Al Gore wrote a book, right? When he was out of the picture. They all wrote books.
Ghostwriters. They did not. Do not give them the credit for writing a book.
And they go on the late show, tonight show, whatever show, to promote their book.
That is a boon that retirees who have invested in IRAs in the market. Sanders supporters need to understand that the only way to make progress in a democracy is to win the election. Not only the presidency, but the ones for Congress. Their divisiveness will not achieve that.
You know what? I could not bear to watch the entire Democratic National Convention because of all the bullshit that I was listening to. But during the Sanders speech, which I felt that most of the things that Bernie Sanders said Hillary either will do or must do. I know she is not going to do them. But it did touch my heart to see the Bernie Sanders supporters in the building crying as he was speaking. And you know, I mean, and then of course there were those that weren't crying but that were angry. Now, I give kudos to the ones who walked out during Hillary Clinton's speech. And I don't blame them for being angry. I mean, you're talking about 15 months of hard work, campaigning, knocking on doors, donating money. I cannot overemphasize that. And yes, Bernie must have known that he was going to get screwed over running as a Democrat. So, you know, all this for naught. For nothing, you know, all this. You know what I mean? Like he could have stood an independent, collected the money, the donations from the little guy. I mean, and it wouldn't be wasted, and he wouldn't have gotten the shaft, as in the rigging.
The John Shan.
Yeah, the whole rigging from the DNC. He wouldn't have gone through that. So yes, he made a pretty big boo-boo that would, I mean, thank God I didn't canvass and go door to door and march in the street, knock on doors and give, I didn't give any money to him because I just didn't like what he said about Edward Snowden being arrested and I didn't like him getting nasty with somebody about, you know, being pro-Israel, and I thought he was way too nice to Hillary Clinton during the debates compared to the way he was with Alan Greenspan way back. So, you know, a red flag came up and I didn't give him any money, and thankfully I didn't, because I would have been much more pissed if I would have donated for something that he probably knew wouldn't have materialized. You know what I mean? I thought all the lawsuits were gonna like, kinda like turn over the apple cart in the convention. I mean, I thought all, you know, all these class action lawsuits and...
Yeah, it's too late now, they probably won't do nothing about it.
And I thought like a dope, thought Loretta Lynch and the FBI was gonna nail Hillary. But I guess the oligarch wins when...
There are different laws for the elites, and there are different laws for the poor.
Well, it's like a monarchy.
Okay.
It's like a monarchy.
Yes, and if that doesn't work out, they will change law. Mr. Comey did.
A monarchy. A monarchy.
He changed the definition. Okay, that's what they do.
G.W. Bush started with the Constitution being just a damn... piece of paper. And Comey did his.
And calling treasuries a file cabinet. Well, treasury bonds.
Well, I hear American money is being printed like confetti.
Yes, it has been. It
doesn't really have any worth.
No.
You know.
Well, actually, no paper money has any worth.
Yes.
It's all a myth.
So the only two currencies worth a damn is the euro and the, what is it, the yen?
No, the euro's
Martin in yen, the yang.
They're paper. None of them are worth anything. You have to meet and make exchange rates and this, that, and the other thing. But the paper money doesn't mean anything. It's not backed with anything.
What's the Chinese
anymore?
Currency
no gold.
Again? The Martin yen?
Yang.
The yang.
Y-U-A-N, the yang. It's got another name too, but
so the yen and the euro, those are the only two left that probably far surpass the US dollar.
I don't know if they surpass, they get exchange rates.
The US dollar, how much could it be worth?
Yeah, but the Chinese yuan, is they keep it low so that their trade is never like ours.
Oh.
They keep theirs very, very low. They cheat. They cheat on exchange rates.
I bet the stock.
So their goods are cheaper.
I bet there's a lot of finagling with these stock exchanges too.
Well, who knows what the stock is? The stock exchange, you know, who owns all the stocks in this country?
The fat cats.
That's right. The fat cats and big corporations or big universities.
Shares.
Or stuff like
shares
that.
Shares go up,
hedge
up,
funds.
Up. Shares go up, 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 and then they split the shares. They split. A stock split, and the rich get richer, the middle class disappear, and the poor are more destitute. Blah, 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 the same old crap.
I read about Governor Christie's talk of a career beyond New Jersey.
I'm sure he has aspirations for bigger and better things.
Isn't that what we have seen for the last 2 years?
Don't open up a restaurant, Chris Christie, because you'll go out of business, man. You'll suck down all the inventory.
Certainly he hasn't spent any time here doing his job. But what was really laughable was the uninformed opinion of a Michigan Republican convention delegate who said he'd put him in as Attorney General. Yes. Since some of his top advisors are either guilty of felonies or awaiting trial for felonies, Christie does seem to be an expert in criminal behavior.
Wasn't Chris Christie personally involved at that time when they arrested so many New Jersey mayors? Corrupt New Jersey mayors?
Oh, yeah, that was a great time. I wonder if they all got convicted.
Remember that? All the mayors that were rounded up to corrupt. I mean, if that was part of Christie's doing, then he's good at going after people. Then he might.
As a micromanager who line item vetoes budget provisions with ease and with no concern for the wishes of New Jersey citizens, anyone who thinks that our beloved governor had no knowledge of any of these questionable activities like Bridgegate is more than welcome to make an offer on a bridge over the Hudson River.
Gee, whatever happened to Bridgegate?
Supposedly it's supposed to come up before the election. Supposedly.
Everything goes on the back burner when there's a big election coming up, I notice.
Yes. A letter writer states that Governor Christie's speech at the convention was an embarrassment to all residents of our state of New Jersey. Shame on that letter writer for equating speaking the truth with embarrassment.
Well, Chris Christie was always more concerned about his own career than the state of New Jersey.
But then again, liberals have never let the truth get in the way of their agenda.
What is our agenda? What is our agenda? Taking care of the poor, taking care of the middle class. Heaven forbid we should care about that.
Christie scored a home run by exposing the biggest fraud ever to be a presidential candidate. Citing facts, Christie pointed out Hillary Clinton's many failures.
I agree with him. I honestly despise Hillary Clinton. You know what? I'm not going to criticize him for that part.
So a big thank you is due, Christie, for speaking the truth. He may have done the Democrats a favor, as next time they may actually have to select a qualified candidate.
Next time I will not be a registered Democrat, because
I'm
skedaddling just like Bernie Sanders did. I am going to bring my application to City Hall. I'm out. The only thing that bothered me is that it doesn't give you the option of writing in what you want to be when you grow up. You know, like they only give you the option of Republican, Democrat, or Independent.
You want to be a communist?
They don't give you like a place to put, I'm a socialist and proud of it. I want to stick it in their craw. Of what kind of system I believe in. I'll say this, son. I'll say. Because I am pissed to the hilt at what the DNC did to Bernice Anders. As Sarah Palin used to call him, Bernice Anders.
Yeah.
Anders. I really, that Jew-faced Deborah Wasser cunt shits
now.
Got away with the wickedness that she pulled.
Yeah.
And is being rewarded.
There you go. It's America for you.
That's right.
That's America for you.
Hey, what's his name? Ollie North got his own radio
that's
show, right?
That's correct, yeah.
Syndicated radio show, remember?
That's that? Correct.
G. Gordon Liddy got one,
he's
too.
On TV with Fox News, too.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah.
I didn't know that.
Oh, yeah.
You know, the cartoon of him has him with very large ears. Does he have big ears?
Yes, he does. They stick out.
I love caricatures.
Dear Abby.
Ah, there we go, the end of the show.
I recently had my lover of 11 years arrested for domestic violence.
Oh.
It was the hardest thing I have ever done. He had me isolated and cut off from the world, and without a family around, I felt extremely lonely and fragile.
Oh, they moved away from her folks.
Looking back, I see how wanting to be loved and not alone caused me to let so many intolerable things happen.
Yeah, my mother had that problem with my dad before I was conceived.
No one should ever have to be bruised and battered physically, psychologically, and verbally by anyone!
No, my mother just endured emotional, verbal abuse, not physical, but yeah. But abuse is abuse, you know what I mean? It's abuse, you know what I mean?
I pray others read this and will do the right thing, which is to press charges, if necessary, and find the strength to leave, as painful as it may be.
If you watch that show Crime Watch Daily, there are many cases of women that did not leave the relationship.
And they're dead.
And they're dead. They're dead.
Dear Abies, answer. I am glad you found the strength to do that. Counseling will help. Trust me on that, readers. I haven't printed the warning signs of an abuser in a while, so here they are. Number one.
Iran, number one.
Remember the Iron Sheik?
Pushes for quick involvement. Comes on strong, claiming I've never felt loved like this by anyone. An abuser pressures the new partner for exclusive commitment. And immediately. Number two.
Interesting.
Jealous.
Well, yeah, that's a given.
Excessively possessive. Calls constantly or visits unexpectedly.
Oh, gosh.
Prevents you from going to work because you might meet someone.
Oh, like when Ralph Cramden used to go, aha! Remember, he found the glove?
Aha, Alice!
He found the glove, the white glove, or the, yeah. Possessive and obsessively jealous, yeah, exactly. Always suspicious of the woman.
checks the mileage on your car.
Oh, man. Oh, that's a nut, man. That's a fucking nut.
Number three.
Spying on you and all that?
Controlling.
If you are late, interrogates you intensely about whom you have talked to,
where you were. Keeps all the money.
Insists you ask permission to go anywhere or do anything.
Number four.
No.
Unrealistic expectations. Expects you to be the perfect mate and meet his or her every need.
Sounds like he wants a sex slave, a concubine of some sort.
Number five. This is the biggie. Isolation.
Isolate, sir?
Tries to isolate you from family and friends.
Very, very controlling nut.
You'll find that a lot of dominance on your dominant and submissive websites and stuff, that is one of the first things they do. She can't talk to no one else. She can't do this with anybody else. Blah, 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 blah.
Her whole world has to be about this chump.
Revolves
her
around
whole existence revolves around this chump.
Exactly.
Accuses people who are your supporters of causing trouble.
People that are trying to help her, yes.
The abuser may deprive you of a phone or a car or try to prevent you from holding a job.
Slavery. You might as well say you're a slave.
Number six. Blames others for problems or mistakes. It's always someone else's fault if something goes wrong. Seven. Makes others responsible for his or her feelings. The abuser says, "You make me angry!" Instead of, "I am angry."
It's like a spoiled child taking a tantrum. And she's
spoiled child having power.
And she, the wife, or the live-in girlfriend, is one of his toys.
You're hurting me by not doing what I tell you.
Possessions. Oh, trying to lay the guilt trip on her.
Number eight.
And this is a very good reading.
Hypersensitivity. He is easily insulted, claiming hurt feelings when he or she is really mad.
Like when Donald Trump can't take any mocking and he wants to punch him in the face,
He's baited by tweets.
Oh, he's getting pissed at tweets?
Yes. Tweets bait him.
Well, the more he flips out, the more people are going to tweet him like that.
The more they're going to understand him. Also.
Yeah, but right. He's providing, you know, they're pushing the buttons and he's going...
He's sucking in.
Hog wild, you know.
He rants about the injustice of things that are just a part of life. Number nine. Cruelty to animals or children.
Oh, that's like one of those... sociopathic, perhaps serial killers? Cruelty, isn't that a telltale sign? Cruelty to animals and to children?
Kills or punishes animals brutally.
Oh, yeah.
Also may expect children to do things that are far beyond their ability.
Oh, yeah, but those are severe telltale signs.
Such as whips a 3-year-old for pissing a diaper.
Oh, jeez. Didn't he ever piss in a diaper before?
Yeah, obviously.
When he was a baby? You know, Crime Watch Daily, this daughter never knew her father had all this child pornography up in his attic, and the father, the old man, got arrested, put in prison. And you know, it's like things that kids never knew about their...
daddies.
Their parents or their uncle or whatever.
65% of abusers who beat their partners will also abuse children. Number 10.
I believe it. How many are there?
15.
Holy crap. All right, go ahead.
Verbal abuse. Constantly criticizes or says blatantly cruel things, degrades, curses, calls you ugly names. This may also involve sleep deprivation, waking you with relentless verbal abuse.
Oh man, she can't even get a good night's sleep.
Number 12. Rigid gender roles expects you to serve, obey, and remain at home. Well, now, I go for a little bit of that.
Yeah, I just don't like gender roles. I don't like gender roles, like, as far as women go, where they say, you're the man, you're supposed to do this and that.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not supposed to do anything. You know, these are, like, usually the women that would make control freak girlfriends and wives.
Number 13. Sudden mood swings.
True.
Switches from sweet to violent in minutes.
Well, these are a lot of red flags.
A lot. 15. 14.
Thank God.
Past battering. Admits to hitting a mate in the past.
Oh, I thought he
likes...
But
says the person made him do it.
I thought that means he has an affinity to deep frying. You know, battering. All right, we're towards
Maybe
the end.
Maybe he can start my car with his battering. Number 15. Threats of violence.
If you don't do this or else.
Says things like,
"Yeah,
I'll break your neck."
Well, I say that, but only towards the forces of evil. I always protect the good.
Or I'll kill you.
I have integrity and honesty beyond belief. Huh? Or I'll kill you. I'll kill you.
And dismisses them with, "Well,
everybody talks that way."
Yeah, right.
I think that's what Mr. Trump does, doesn't he?
Yeah. Hey, you know, Oscar Madison...
Hey, punch him in the face.
Oscar Madison once said, "Felix, I'll kill you." But he was very pissed off. He didn't really mean it. But then when Felix was missing...
It was a figure of speech, I guess.
Yeah, when Felix was missing, he was the number one suspect. "Felix, I'll kill you." But you know, Felix drove him nuts. Hey, it was a figure of speech. It doesn't mean... He's actually going to do.
Well, you gotta see the fruits of the person who's saying it.
Yeah, your pattern. You gotta look at the pattern.
Exactly. Or he may say, "I didn't really mean it." Readers, if you feel you are at risk, contact the National Domestic Violence Hotline at 800-799-7233 or go online to thehotline.org.
You know what? This is a very important... Usually we leave the very light stuff or comical topics for last. But this was not light. This was actually important. And it's a good thing you read this. Because... it's important.
It might help.
It's important.
It might help some people.
It's important to help save a life. Help save the lives of women.
Yes.
Who learn about the red flags and know when to get out.
Get out!
Get out. Now, thank God, law enforcement treats things like this, including stalking and, you know, more seriously than they did in the past.
However,
at one time, it was like the husband's right to get rough with his wife, you know, back in the day.
But most times, you know what I mean? Like if a woman gets a restraining order against a guy, he still comes back and kills her.
That's why
you know, they're like worthless piece of paper.
She needs to pack heat.
Oh!
Eats the pack. Heat! Heat!
A little Derringer.
Yeah, like the... What are the chicks on the... what was that? The Wild Wild... The Riverboat Gamblers. You know, the girls had in their petticoat or their...
In their little garter.
Garters. Garter belts. They had the little Derringer. The one bullet Derringer. Which only works at close range.
Close range, yes.
Because you only have one bullet.
Hey.
But how was the caliber on a Derringer? Was it?
I don't know, but that's what I was thinking. Today, you got some of these guys where you pump them full like with 8-10 shells and they're still coming.
That's because the your typical 38 caliber Glock or Beretta does not have the punch that a 45 caliber...
Yeah, but a lot of the ammunition today, once it goes into your body, it blows up like inside.
You're talking about hollow point bullets.
Whatever they are.
Well,
like in the military and stuff, I mean, they blow up in you.
Well, a hollow point, it like,
yeah,
it goes
out,
in and
yeah.
Then it becomes like buckshot, right? Shreds.
Shrapnel.
Like shrapnel, there you go. That's the word. It becomes, bullet enters, becomes shrapnel. To do more damage, so instead of a clean shot that you could survive possibly,
yeah.
It is a more damaging
absolutely.
Shot. So
absolutely.
Your chances of survival are less.
Mm-hmm.
Lovely. All lovely.
Of course, if the Derringer bullet goes in, it will cause a little pain for you. Maybe enough time for her to get the hell out of there.
Well, if it's of a decent caliber,
yeah.
And since it's close range, your accuracy is bound to be... very good, unless you are as blind as a bat, or stupid as all hell. You know, usually close range is a piece of cake. But the key to something like a Derringer, like a Saturday Night Special, is its concealability.
Uh-huh.
It can easily go in a pocket, so mm-hmm. you catch your perpetrator off guard.
Unaware.
They're unaware that you have something like that.
You're packing heat, man.
Packing heat, man. Yeah. Packing heat. Packing heat.
Yeah.
Like the porno stars, right? They were packing heat. The legendary porno stars.
I know nothing about them.
Okay. That's it. Fini, we're done. Have a good week. Enjoy the rest of the weekend. This is our new...
Yeah, take a porno star to lunch.
This
okay?
is our new... I'm sure Charlie Sheen did plenty of...
All right, Charlie Sheen and Dice, decent guy. Take a porno star to lunch.
No. Charlie Sheen hung out with the female porno stars.
Yes, of course.
I'm not saying Charlie Sheen is
because
the porno
he could.
Star. Because he could,
yeah.
He's good. But he, when he got fired from that show, whatever he said about Hollywood happened to be correct. They just, you know, people don't like to be told the truth. If you hit a raw nerve, they usually don't like that. What did George Carlin say? He said, everyone seems to appreciate total honesty until you're honest about them, then they call you an asshole. God rest his soul, George Carlin. You know what I mean? Which mm-hmm. is true. They
of
want they want honesty. They love it until it involves them.
It impinges them, yes.
Right. We'll see. Say so long to these jabronis.
So long, jabrones.
This has been a Megalife 21 production.